Hey guys, welcome to Testing Academy. My name is Pramod and welcome to the 30 days of automation in testing. This is a day 12, right? In this video, we are going to talk about the top 29 commands that I think you should know as a QA, right? These are the commands includes like iframe, handling of windows and many more, right? So let's jump into it and see what are the top 29 commands, right? So guys, before starting out, we are on a mission to learn automation testing in 30 days. And this is the day 12 where we are learning new concept related to automation and testing, right? If you want to see all the tasks related to it, you can go to this URL. And if you want to download the resources or anything related to this video and all, you can definitely go to this window, this URL. If you want to discuss anything with me, you can go to apitesting.co/chat. Where definitely I can help you if you have any kind of doubt, right? And last thing, we have 1200 plus members who are part of the software testing community where we discuss about Selenium, API testing and many more concepts. Go join the testingacademy.com and trust me, you're gonna learn a lot, right? So let's jump into the top Selenium commands. So let's start with the basic one. So it's a long list, but let's start with a simple one, right? So the first one is very simple, guys. It's related to the driver.get, which is basically opens any kind of a URL. So before that, what you need to do is that you need to start or initialize your web driver, right? In the previous video where I have discussed basically about the Selenium tutorial, right? That part one, right? We have basically made our Hello World program where we have initialized the web driver, right? So now if you want to open google.com, you can definitely use the driver.get where you in the string part, in the argument part, you need to pass the website that you want to load, right? If you want to get the current URL, you can use the driver.current URL. And if you want to get the title with that, you basically all the website have a title. So let me show you what do you mean by this. Is that, for example, this is a website, and in the developer tools, if I type document dot title, right? So this is the title, right? The title is internet in this case. So this we want to verify, right? That we can do. So let's jump into the very one advanced concept, which is related to the window handling, right? So I've given this demo and this mind map will be available to you in the description. So don't worry, don't just copy paste. Means you can get the concept. So let's get the concept first, right? So this is the URL. If you go to this URL and if you click this button, right, it will open a new window, right? So these are two windows. Let's close this also. So let's close this one. So if I click it, there are like two windows open, right? This one is the primary window, which is called as main window. And this is the second window, which is, you can call it as a secondary window. I want to basically verify the new window, or if I want to verify the title, how I can do this, right? So it is a very simple way. So let me show you how you can handle that thing, right? So let's jump into the code directly. So what we are doing is that we are basically getting it. So we are just opening the URL in this case. And after that, I'm just clicking this button, which is basically this one, right? So this is the path of it. And let's jump back to the source code. And after that, if you do driver.get window handle, right? So get window handle is it will give you the handle of the current window, which is right now, the window is this one, right? So it will print the print the window handle. Window handle is nothing but it's a very long hash that which in the string format. So that will be printed here. So let me show you how this looks like. So let's comment down full thing because we're going to discuss lots of different things. So let's see demo till now. Till now that we have discussed, we can get the URL. We can get the current URL and we can use a assert, which is basically the assert I'm using for JUnit, right? And before running this test case, I'm going to share this code with you. So don't worry. Make sure you download the Selenium server, commons.io for file operation, and JUnit for basically using the assert framework, right? So just add it to the module settings. So if you download the IntelliJ like you have done in the previous video, go to module setting. Right, and here in the modules you can add the jars, right? Click on the plus icon, add the jars, and after that you are good to go. You can use these jars now, right? So we have just opened the URL, verified the current URL, get the title, right? And after that what we are doing is we are basically moving to the windows handle, right? So let's run this work project, which is the commands. So let's run it and see what is the window handle getting printed in that case, right? So it is started it. It is going to start now. And here you can see the Google Chrome is starting. And the first thing first is that we'll open login page, which is simple one, just to show the demo of driver.get. And after that, as you can see, it has opened the second window also. So we have clicked the basically a button, and after that we get the handle, right? So if you see, this is how it looks like. It's basically CD window and certain hash, right? So this is basically, it is printing the, this is for this window, parent window, right? But we are not sure if this there means how many windows are open. We don't know that, right? So what we can do is that we can use this thing. So let me comment down. So you can use the function which is called as driver.getWindowHandles with the S. So it will return a set. This set will contains the two windows, basically the first one and the second one, right? And after that, what you can do is that you can basically, what I have done is that I have converted into the array list, and after that I can switch to 0 and 1 depending upon the choice I made, right? So let's run this demo now. And if you see, so it is running as of now. Yeah, great. Chrome, yes, it has opened. And now the first one will be the login page, which is very simple to just open it. And yes, now we have switched back to, right? So yeah, as you can see. So what we have done is that in this case is basically this one is getting printed. And what we right now, if you see the focus in the main window, right? And so what we have done is basically we have used this function which is switch to, and we are switching to the second window, which is this one, and we are doing the get title in this case, right? And we are printing the title. So that title is printed. It means we have basically switched to that window and get the title, and after that we have switched back. So if suppose I have, suppose let me show you, if we don't switch back, it will still be basically have a focus on that second window. Okay, so if you want to get back to the parent window, you need to do this basically to use the switch to method. And here, right, so let's see the demo again. And here if you see, right, it is open, and see the second window's focus is there, right? So it means this thing works. Make sense? Cool, right? So let me close this, right, so that we can have some thing, right? This is how you work with get windows and get window handles, right? So get window handles basically returns a windows hash. You can use basically, if you use singular one, which is single one, it will return the current window handle, which is a hash. If you do window handles, it will return a set in the case of Java, right? You can, if you want to handle a drop down, what you can do is you can use a select class, right? So what you need to do is that, also let me show you that demo. So this one, no, drop down. So there it is, a drop down. And if you see, we have drop down with the two option, right? So let's see what is the ID of this thing. So this the select, it is a select tag with the ID of drop down, and it has option one and option two, right? So how you can work with it, I have prepared a demo for you especially, right? And what you can do, it's very simple in this case actually, right? So what you need to do is that you can use select box with the ID. So let me show you with this one, right? So you can use the select class, which is available somewhere, it is available, right? Because we are doing star, I guess, so that's why it is not available. We are creating a select, new select, and we need to pass the ID of the drop down. So drop down ID is drop down, and we can use select by visible text, which is the option one, right? So let me show you, like there are two more options available. For example, you can do select by index also, or you can do select by value also. So if you know the value of it, right? So there are two options that you can do. So let's see the quick demo for it, and let's see if it is running fine or not. So I just started the execution. So guys, why we are doing this thing, this exercise, because in the day 15 we are gonna automate a Namecheap domain server. So that will basically, for that thing we need to know these kind of Selenium commands, and these commands are important, and definitely with 8 years experience I have, right, these are the important ones, and basically these are the commands you will be using throughout your automation scripts whenever you are creating it, right? So if you see, we have successfully selected the option one also, right? So let's close it and clear it out, right? So now we have a very simple demo which was previously discussed also. So it is nothing but about the finding elements and clicking it. So it was login scenario that we have done in the previous window, right? And couple of command I would like to highlight. Top commands were related to finding element by name, by this thing. We can use signed keys to send the data to basically enter into the input box. You can click it using the click function, right? And current URL that we have already discussed, right? So let's discuss about the important concept, which is iframe now, okay? So let iframe plus screenshots. So and this is gonna be a very important topic, right? So what we have here is that, so let me show you what we are doing. So let's open a iframe, right? So if you see, we have a editor, right? And in the editor you can type something. For example, we can type something, right? So this editor, actually this is a iframe that is somewhere present, and this is right now we are using into this one, and I want to type into this, basically I want to type this some hello world message into it, right? So how I can do that, right? So what I can do is that, let me show you. So what we are doing is, we are basically using it, we are opening the URL and we are maximizing it. So this is another important command to maximize a window. And after that, what you need to do is that you need to get the ID or name of this iframe. So let's click here, right? And if you see, if you go above, right? So this has an ID, right? So you need to get the ID or the name of it. So here, if you see, they have mentioned name or an ID. So if you have ID of the iframe, you can switch to that iframe. So you are now in the iframe. And now what you need to do is, you need to just click on that element. So I need to find the ID of this text box, which is, I'm not sure what it's a text box or something else, but let's see what is it. So it is a body actually. Yeah, so it's at the body which contain the tiny MICE, right? So what I am doing here is that I'm using another command, important command, which is clear, which will basically clear everything which is previously available. I'm going to type the hello Pramod. Right, and now the important command, which is our next important Selenium command, is screenshot. Right, text screenshot. Yes. Right. What we are doing in this demo is that we are basically dealing with the iframe as well as we are taking the screenshot also, and we have like learn multiple commands like send keys, clear files, output file directories, handling copying the source file to destination file using screenshot. Right, couple of commands. Go through the source code, you will definitely understand it. I will recommend you to open this source code and try out with your own and try to understand this one, right? So let me run this demo again and let's see what's going on, right? So this is like a first one, which is basically just opening a URL. After that we have run the get window handle, selection, username, password, verifying the username, password, iframe, and now we have opened the iframe, we have maximized it. I'm going to type hello Pramod, I'm going to take the screenshot, and we are done in behind if you see. So let's open the IntelliJ, and here, right, we have b.png. let me stop this one, right? And we have b.png, let's open it. Yes, and we have a screenshot available, right? So that is again an important command that we have learned, right? So let's move on to the last one. Let me close this thing. So let's move on to the last one, which is important for us to learn about it, right? So what you can do is that we have seen. So what we are doing is we are again opening the iframe page, and I'm going to type about the page load time, right? I have mentioned 5 seconds. So it will take a little time to load it out. So page load late timeout basically means if a page is not getting loaded with the 5 second, then we are gonna do that. Isko remove, right? Right, guys. So what we are doing is that we are opening an iframe in this case, and what we have done is this is the expected condition. So what I want to do is that until I found, until the visibility of my iframe is available, I don't want to run the next command, right? So what I can do is that I have added an expected wait, which is basically using the WebDriver wait, I'm gonna type the maximum 4 seconds. So it is in time in seconds, timeout in seconds, right? Timeouts in minutes. So let's call it 4, right? So I want to, for example, let's say 40 seconds. So I want to wait till 40 seconds until the visibility of my iframe is available, until my iframe is clickable, until the presence of my iframe is available, right? So these are like couple of different expected waits, and in the waits, basically I have created one more video about the waits in Selenium. I will recommend you to watch it, because those things we are going to use into the day 15, where we are automating a domain search algorithm, right? So I am just waiting for it, and if I found within 50, means if I am not able to find till 40 second, it will throw an exception in that case, right? So let's run the demo as of now and see if our expected condition works fine, right? If you are not able to catch it or not able to grasp it as of now, I'll recommend you to go and watch the waits in Selenium video where I have discussed about the implicit, explicit wait and fluent wait, right? So that is important concepts. Right now we are working with the username password. These are like another command, iframe, maximizing window, hello promote, again opening the iframe, and right, and expected condition works, so everything works well, right? So that's all about it, about this, and I hope you have learned some new commands in this case. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video.